Hi everyone, I'm Ellie from Code of the Future, and today I'm going to be showing you how to plot graphs in Python. So as always, I'm going to put my glasses on and move you onto the screen. Okay, so we've jumped straight into PyCharm. I have created a file called graphs in Python, ready for us to do a bit of coding. So the first thing I'm going to say is being able to plot in Python, you know, draw different types of graphs in Python is vital for if you want to pursue a career in data analysis, or if you are just really interested in creating graphs and observing data. So again, that is one of the most important things we can use plots for, is observing data. Obviously, you'll see at the moment, especially in England, when they are holding coronavirus briefings and they show the data, everything is done on a plot so you can see, you know, the impact of how coronavirus is, for an example. But we're not going to talk about coronavirus today, we're going to move away from that. We're going to start by plotting graphs in Python. They are, as I said, they are incredibly useful, and being able to do so, I think, is probably one of the most rewarding things you can do as a beginner, especially if you are wanting to pursue a career in data analysis. So enough of me talking, I'm going to jump straight in and we're going to do plots in Python. So the first thing that we're going to say is, obviously I've just written this hashtag at the top just to say plotting graphs in Python. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to assign x as a list, and we're going to call it, and we're going to make it a list from, let's say, 1, 3, 5, and then 10. Just a random list. Okay, so that's our x. Okay, so we say we have this list, and say, oh, well, I want to plot this on a graph. I want to see how, you know, the x-axis changes. So what I'm going to say is, before we can do any type of plotting, we need to import a specific module. And what we're going to do is, just at the top of here, we're going to drop this down. I'm going to put importing the relevant modules. Okay, and what we're going to say is we're going to say import matplot, and it's there, plotlib dot pyplot as plt. Now, if you do a lot of graph plotting, you will get used to remembering this off the top of your head. To start with, you might think, well, that's a really long import. You know, what is it doing? It's essentially importing the relevant module for us to be able to plot. And we are calling it plt because when we go to plot, instead of writing matplotlib.pyplot, we just say plt and then it will plot it for us. Okay, so I'm going to jump straight in and show you exactly what will happen if, say, we get this x and we say, okay, well, let's say plt, which is what we've defined up here. We say plt dot dot plot and plot x. Okay, now if we run this, what I'll show you is if we run this, nothing happens. And the reason that is because you need to say plt dot show and just open brackets. What this does is it will show this plot. So we've asked it to show. So if we run this Python file again, hey, there we go. We've got our first plot in Python. Obviously, it's a very, very basic plot. You know, the axes aren't labelled, we don't really have a lot going on. So this is a very, very basic plot. This isn't something that we want to produce in Python. We want to label the axis, we want to, you know, get a corresponding y-axis, get a title, make it look a lot neater. But this is just showing you the basic way of plotting a very, very simple graph. So have a go at this, see if you can get something similar. So we're going to just cross off that for now. And crossing off it will subsequently stop the Python file from running. Equally, if you click run, and it pops up here. When you go back onto here, what you'll notice is because this is still up and running, when you go back onto your Python file, the Python file is still running. So another way you can get rid of this plot is to just by pressing this stop button. So we're gonna put here very basic plot. We want something better. Okay, so, and I'm just gonna put in here this is what we are plotting. Okay, and then we're going to just put here, this will show the plot we are plotting. Okay, so that's a very, very basic plot. We don't want something like that. We want something very, very nice, you know, different colors. Let's explore it a little bit further. But first, before we go a bit crazy and start changing colors and getting titles, I'm just going to show you how you can do it with a y-axis as well. So say we have x again, and x is obviously already called here. Let's say x is 4 students' shoe size. Obviously a size 1 is a little bit extreme, but let's say it's 4 students' shoe size. And then let's y equal their age. So a size 1, I think maybe you'd be, oh, don't know. I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. I can't remember how old I was when I got a size 1 shoe. But let's say you were 7. And then a size 3 shoe, let's say you're around 12, and then a size 5 shoe. Well, I'm a size 5 shoe now, so let's say we're 21, And then a size 10, let's say something similar, usually by the time you're an adult, you have grown into your shoe size. So let's say 22. Okay. So what we can do is we can plot these two things against each other, and what we'll notice is, you know, as age increases, shoe size increases. Again, this is where data analysis comes in really handy, but for now we're just going to show you a very, very basic example. Okay, so let's say we have y, and let's say we want to plot y against x. Again, we can do what we did above, and remember, this is a very, very basic plot. There's nothing labelled. This is not the type of plot that you want to be producing if, say, you're doing it for a university kind of level. But for the time being, I'm just going to show you, you can plot two different lists against each other. So we're going to just say plt.plot x, y. And again, we'll say plot show. Now, what's worth noting is that this will show before this one. So the way that we can overcome that is we can either run this and it will show this one first and then this one, or we can just comment this out. But I'll just, for the ease of it, I'll show you what will happen. So we'll click run. And notice this is the very first one that we had. And then if we cross off this, there we go. There's the next one. Okay, so perfect. We can plot two lists against each other. Now I'm going to jump straight in and show you exactly how you can create two different lines and plot them against each other. Nice plots, your own colours, axis titles and titles. So a very, very kind of formal plot that you would expect to see when doing some sort of data analysis. So this is obviously a very basic plot, and again we're just going to say here plotting x and y against each other. And what I forgot to mention, although it did seem slightly intuitive when I said, you know, if you are size 1 you are age 7, what this will do, it will plot 1 and 7, 3 and 12, 5 and 21, and 10 and 22. That's how it works in Python. So if I was to write here 23 and click run, we will get an error. The first one runs because the first one's fine. We go across and we have an error because it says the lists must be the same shape. Here we have a list of 4 and here we have a list of 5. So that's just something to bear in mind, is if something like this pops up, it just means your lists don't have the same type of entries. Okay, so we have these, and for the ease of this, we're just going to comment, you know, the plot show out, because every time we run, we don't want to be plotting those really poorly plotted graphs. I'm going to move down, and this is where the fun starts. So we're going to say, let's plot a lovely looking plot. And obviously, I'm not sure that's how you describe it in data analysis, but I say let's plot something that looks nice. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to say, okay, line 1. And these are going to be points. Okay, so we're going to assign a new x and y variable just because we want something new. So okay, let's say 3, 9, 15. Actually, we'll do 14. And then we're going to say y equals 2, 7, 11. Okay, so they're line 1 points. This is the first line that we're going to draw. Again, this is exactly what we did last time. We have two lists and they are both the same shape, which is what we want. So we have the points. Now let's plot these. Okay, so as before, let's just put a comment and say plotting x and y. So we're going to say plt plot. Okay, so this is what we did before, but now we're going to say x comma y comma, and this is where you can start putting some information about how you want the plot to look. So last time we got a plot that had blue. Say you don't like the colour blue and you want the colour red. The way that you'll do that is you will say C equals red. Okay, and for red to work, it has to be a string, so it has to be in these quotation marks. Similarly, you can say, well, let's have line width. Look, it's automatically set to 1, I believe, in Python. So let's say we want it to be a little bit bigger. Let's say we'll do 2, which will make it a little bit chunkier. Python likes you to keep these, PyCharm, sorry, likes you to keep these close together, which is absolutely fine. And then finally, we're just going to say label. Now, what a label means is, once we finish writing the appropriate code at the end, we can ask Python to produce a legend. Now, if you're not familiar with what a legend is, it basically means you have a plot and say you have two different lines. A legend will tell you exactly what color corresponds to which line. So in this case, this is our line 1. So let's say our label is going to equal line 1. I'll show you what this does to start with. So let's say plot show. And as before, we have defined these things here. So we're just going to comment these out just for ease, because what will happen is if you ask Python to plot something here, and plot it here and then you plot it here, all of these will end up on the same graph. There is a way that you can overcome that, is by saying plot figure. We're not going to touch upon that today, that will be in a later video. This is just showing you a very, very simple plot. Okay, so we've just commented everything else out just because we don't want any more overlapping of anything that we've done previously. And also I'm just going to change this 11 to a relatively larger number, just so we can see the difference in points, just because I think those numbers were getting a little bit too close to each other. We're going to click run. Aha, perfect. So we've got a red line and it's thicker than it was before. Okay, now notice no legend has popped up, and that's because we haven't asked Python to recall a legend just yet. But we've managed to get it red and we've managed to get the line width bigger. Okay, so that's the first thing we've done. Now we're just going to stop it up here and we're going to move on to plotting. We're just going to get rid of this plot show because we don't want to plot it just yet, because we're going to add some few things onto the graph before we eventually show it. So we've got rid of that. Now we're going to say line to points. Okay, so we're going to do line 2 points. Okay, so instead of x we're going to have x2, because this is a different list to this one. So let's have 1, 15, 18, and y2 is going to equal 0, 3, 12. Okay, and again plotting x2 and y2, and we'll say plt.plot x2 Y2, we're going to let the colour, what colour should we have it this time? Let's say green. Getting in the Christmas spirit, it's almost Christmas, I mean it's not almost Christmas, we're in November, but anyway, I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. Then line width, and we're going to do a different line width this time, just so you can see how line widths change. So we're going to say 0.5. Now this will produce quite a thin line. Now we're going to say label, and this is going to be line 2. Okay, perfect. So again, if I put a little plot show here and we run this Python file, there we go, we've got two different lines. And if I just expand this, you can see that this line is a lot thicker than this line, and this line here is also thinner. Okay, so we've done that, we've got two lines, we've got different kind of colours and stuff. For the ease of the video, just for the niceness of the plot, we're going to take the line width back to 2, so it's in line with this one. And we're going to get rid of this plot show because we want to add a few extra things on, so the axis labeling and everything like that. Okay, so now we're going to say label the axes. Okay, so we're going to say plt.xlabel, and we're going to label it. So in this case we could go back with the shoe size thing, but I'm not sure a 3-year-old will have size 15 feet. I think that might be a bit excessive. So for the ease of this video, we're just going to say this is the x-axis. And similarly, we'll say plt.ylabel, and we're going to say y-axis. Okay, so that's the labeling the axes there. That's how we do it. You can put anything in here that you want according to what it is. So if it was shoe size, you know, we would say x was, I think it was shoe size, and y was age. So this would be shoe size and that would be age. Okay. So we've done labelling the axes. Now I'm just going to put up here and give the plot a title, because obviously we always want a title on a plot. So again, we're going to put plt.title, very simple. And the title is going to be two lines. Simple. So we've labelled the axes and we've labelled the title. Now what we're going to do is show the legend on the plot. And what this will do is it will show these labels we've given to each of the plots. Okay, so show legend on the plot, all you need to do is say plt.legend, very, very simple. And then finally, we're going to say get Python to show the plot. And we're going to put plt.show as before, and we're going to click run. Hey, there we go, perfect. So we've got a title, it says two lines, we've got our little legend here, so we know that this is our line one and this was our line two. We have y-axis labelled and we have x-axis labelled. Okay, perfect. So we have plotted a very, very nice two lines. We can extend this a little bit further, which is what I'm going to talk about now. So if you are content with plotting graphs now, you know, you've had a little go, then you don't have to watch the rest of the video. The rest of the video is kind of showing you how you can change to scatter plots and have kind of cool little lines in between. So that's what I'm going to talk about now. It's not going to take as long, I promise, but we're going to get into it straight away now. So let's just cross off this Python file here. Sorry, I meant graph. Okay, so I'm gonna just extend on what we've done already. Instead of creating a brand new graph, we're gonna extend on what we've done already. So we're gonna keep line one as it is, and we're gonna adjust line two just to show you how you can change the lines and make them look a little bit nicer. So here we've got all these kind of extra factors for this line. So we have the colour is green, we've got the line width is 2, and the label is line 2. Now we can add some extra things into here to make it look a little bit funkier, as it were. So we can add some extra things into here other than just line width and colour and things. So the first thing we're going to say is, okay, let's have the line style as dashed. And what that does, instead of a line, it does a dash, which is going to look pretty cool already. I'm going to put a comma in here and we're just going to enter. Now if you click enter and we still have these two brackets set up, then we can still type in here. It just saves me having to go all the way over here. Now at each point, obviously all these points are being joined together. Now at each point, let's say we want to have a marker at each point. So what we're going to do is we're going to say marker equals O. And we're just going to put those back together because that's what it likes. So I'm going to run this and I'm just going to show you exactly what this is going to do. So we'll run in Python. And there we go. Look at that. We've got a nice marker in between. We've got a nice little dashed line. Notice here the legend has also adapted to that as well. Okay, cool. We've got something like that. Let's say we want to change the colour of the marker. So let's say marker face colour. And we're going to let it equal to, let's say orange. Orange and green. Let's see how that looks. We stop the Python file running and we run again. Error. And do you know why? And this is perfect because I've been meaning to try and get errors in my Python code so that I can talk you through exactly what's happened. Okay. And I know straight away what I've done because I do this all the time and you'll probably end up doing it at some point. Is you need to remember that colour is the American spelling, and obviously here I've put a U in. So we just get rid of the U and then we'll click run. And perfect. There we go. So now we have our little markers with orange, which I think looks quite cute, to be honest. It looks quite nice. And now I'm just going to show you one last thing, is you can say, let's say marker size equals, and let's make this really big, let's say it's 10. And you can guess what this does, because we are plotting markers at the moment. It makes these markers really, really big. And that's quite nice if you've got like a lot of data and you want to see exactly where the points are. Doing that will help as well. What's worth noting is markers don't just have to be like this. You can put S and stop running and go again. And it draws squares this time. This is just to show you how you can change line graphs in Python. There is a whole list of all the different markers you can use, the different colours. So after this video, after you've watched this video, then just experiment, see what you can do, see kind of what different plots you can make in Python and have a play around with the different colours and everything. The final thing that I'm going to say is you can actually give the axis limits as well, so limits of the axis. And we're just going to say plt.ylim. So we can give the axis limits. Say we only want it between 1 and 10. And similarly for x. Obviously this is going to cut a lot of our data off because our data was within quite a large value. So let's say 0 and let's say this is 30. Let's say we want to keep, you know, a large scale for the x-axis. So let's stop running this and we'll run it again. And notice here that it has only done between 0 and 30 for the x, which is what we asked it to do, and 1 and 10 for the y. So this is a way of being able to kind of hone in a little bit. And also another thing to say with PyCharm as well is you get this little toolbar down here. So if you have this, you can move like this. So this is showing you the plot and it will go all the way up to 30 it was, yeah. So this is kind of like a scroll button so you can move around. This here is a zoom button, so I could zoom in like this and it will zoom in. And again, you can save the plot here and you can save it to your desktop, and I can put two lines, exclamation mark, we can save it. I will go onto my desktop and here it is. I can open it and it's there. And that's how you save in PyCharm. But that is the video. I am hoping to do shorter videos on very specific types of graphs, so say a pie chart, histogram, all the different types of graphs. I hope you liked the video. If you did, then please like, subscribe and comment, and I will see you all in the next video.